Good morning, everybody. Shall we begin?
So first up, we're going to be talking about student entertainment. The girls have come to me and have asked me whether or not they can do it this year. Thoughts? How are we feeling? Should they be allowed to do it? Come at me.
Well, as the child protection officer, I think we need to think about the children.
Drama. Mrs. Kelly, it's your area. How are you feeling? Do you think the girls are responsible enough?
So, these dudes, I think, are my favourite year, and I think we should just give them free rein to do whatever they want to do. They are outstanding performers, and I've given them amazing roles in all of my play because they truly are amazing.
Drama already takes up so much of the academic schedule.
PE, what do you think?
I'm not even part of the PE department anymore. I'm head of tennis. I don't even know them.
Exams are 250 days away. We do not have the time for this.
Oh, Mr. Sheldon, you rock my world.
I mean, it's really not very ladylike, is it? We've got to think that they're young ladies.
But how will this affect our after-school tennis lesson?
But I really believe that these girls can pull it off, unlike previous years.
Frankly, I don't give up.
Queensford, me and Anne and I, we were out to do whatever we wanted.
Yeah. Is it just me, or is something a bit different today?
Oh, hush, Stephen, there's nothing wrong with the stuff.
Could I just volunteer myself to be in? If it would help sort of control or moderate them, maybe?
No, it's a stupid question. Very, very, very stupid. Question. It's about the independent learning. It's A level. Independent learning.
When are we going back to the Barbican? It's the only way I can get girls into choir.
Yes, but what about the children?
We are gathered here today to discuss whether the girls should do student entertainment or not.
Banter.
Safeguarding is everyone's responsibility.
We must talk about the academics here.
Everybody!
What is the uncle?
Two ears, one mouth. God gave you two ears and one mouth.
Trap the dude's creativity.
I crave approval.
They just gotta let it out. They just gotta eat the pasta, kids!
Okay, everybody quiet. I've decided we're gonna let them do it. What could possibly go wrong?
And we just wanted a few comments from you about how your first year at Queenswood has been.
I've had a wonderful first year at Queenswood. The girls have been fabulous. They're so well behaved. They are lovely, lovely young women.
One.
Have you done a timer?
Shut up! Only at Queenswood would there be a fire alarm during filming.
It's probably Clapham North.
Really young ladies is what I would call them.
Hello.
It's too lonely, I'm in the same old lines.
Hello.
Here at Queenswood, we have a tough love policy.
Sister, I think I've broken my leg. It really hurts. It got caught in a chapel stampede.
Those animals. Obviously, some of the girls are quite sensitive, so we just give them something and send them on their way.
Sensitive.
Where's your policy, Tom?
Go and take it some water.
Are you meant to be in there?
Cross country. cross country. I think I need to lie down.
Okay, dear. Go and have a lie down.
When something as serious as this happens, we tend to get a lot of girls in here, so we just try and tend to them the best we can through this troubled time.
Here we have the Year 7 out in the open. She's taking her first steps into the wilderness. We can see that on her back she carries a heavy backpack full of useless stuff that she would later on realise she does not need. See how she runs 10 minutes early to class to avoid the stampede. She has begun her journey to become the Queenswood girl. The next stage in this girl's life cycle is known as the previous teenus, otherwise known as the Year 9. She's in a state of confusion, not knowing her place in the Queenswood food chain, ahead of lower school but at the bottom of middle school. She is a long way from developing into the Year 11. As you can see, the Year 11 has become much more confident being out in the open and is full of pride knowing that she now rules over the middle school. But what's this? Ah yes, the rare sixth former. I can't believe it, we've never seen one so close before. As you can see, she wears the protective armour of a fluffy robe, preventing her from getting sick in this vital stage of her development. See how her blinking pattern has become far more erratic due to the extensive amounts of caffeine she has digested from her unnecessarily large Sports Direct mug. She hasn't slept since Brexit.
Yeah!
The inspector's a-coming!
Sister,
So you're telling me none of you have a file? No gun? No one has a file for all of the work I've been giving you all year!
The inspectors are here!
Sitting back, but of course, why don't we meet our pink windmill kids?
Hi, my name's Katrina.
And my name is Hugh.
I'm Sarah.
I'm Emma.
And I'm Jo to you.
Hello, my name is Spencer.
And mine is Lorraine.
I'm Anthony.
I'm Debbie.
And my name is Abby.
Hello.
Welcome to Queenswood School. I am Mrs. Cameron, and in this short film, I shall virtually tour you around one of Q's gems, the palaestra. With its mouldy green colouring and exposed steelwork beams, it is the perfect modern sports hall for any school. Who needs bricks when you have corrugated iron? This hall is spacious and echoing and barren. The interior may be a bit chilly, but who doesn't like a bit of frostbite in the summer? Bit exotic, isn't it, for Hertfordshire? One thing that can be said about the palaestra is that it's a very stable structure, only known for bits of debris to fall when a netball sometimes bounces against the wall, but that rarely happens. Fortunately, soon enough we'll have to say goodbye to this delightful piece of Queenswood history. It shall surely be missed. I'm not too sure why it needs renovating, if I'm honest. It seems perfectly fine to me. Well, modern technology.
Now here's the trick, let's make this quick. Buy a brick from this chick. Excuse me?
Yep.
Do you want to buy a brick?
Why would I want to buy a brick?
It's for our sports hall. It should be up and running this September.
Right, so how many people have bought a brick so far?
Two. Just our parents.
Okay, how much will it cost?
500.
Yeah, can I put it on the bill?
Yes, absolutely.
Brilliant.
Jonah, I think someone's coming!
coming! Oh, a bioprick!
Bioprick!
Oh, they've got it. Oh, never mind. Please! Somebody! Bioprick!
Hello.
Look, you go. I'll help you out. You'll have to keep up. Get left behind and there's no turning back.
You'll get the grades,
but you'll pay the price.
Just keep your head down and don't follow him.
It's every girl for herself in this classroom.
And it's a good thing you're not late.
What? Why?
The eagle lands in 5!
We only have 26 laps to take note of everything.
4!
What do you mean laps?
3!
Heads down!
2!
Hands at the ready!
1!
Right, girls, Thomas Hardy, the Darkling Thrush. We're talking Hope and the Bird. But what is Hardy really on about here? Is he scared of the future? This is probable.
Hello.
I say the same thing twice. I'm awkward when I speak.
Come on, look at him.
Don't look at the camera! That was really good, but don't.
Sorry,
can we just film a few shots for starts? Oh, right. Sorry. Oh my god. I hate you.
Working with a bunch of amateurs.
Yeah. Out the shot.
Sister, we've got another
one. It's gonna
be a long day.
Go and lie down.
Don't lie down.
Guys, I think I'm the worst.
You'll get great. You
just keep your head down. Don't follow him.
Elgrace, you're the one. Go. That wasn't a go for you, Aoife, for f***ing sake, leave!
Ah! Hand cramp!
Keep
it's all red, you're not alone.
I can't hear my chest.
Have you actually?
That's nice.
Can I get you your eyes? Oh my god! You're a bloody disgrace. Asking the sick form to do a little bit of exercise. Not okay!
That's nice. It's a rare Emily. I like it.